the American Constitution. As usual, we have been deceived by the New World Order bankster secret societies. Now if you go into any court of America to argue the constitutionality of any issue, you are told that the Constitution has no effect or authority in this court and is now null and void. Therefore now, you have no constitutional rights in any court of the USA today. It has been replaced with the Patriot Acts. The American government is now a despotic and tyrannical institution, run by despots who are part of the New World Order. This was planned when the Masonic Founding Fathers wrote the Constitution. They knew that this phrase would one day destroy the Constitution. Just see Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17. It says, Congress shall have the power to exercise exclusive legislation in all cases whatsoever over such districts as may become the seat of the government of the United States, which means Washington. Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17 was included as a result of proposals made to the Constitutional Convention by the Mason James Madison. So it is now to be said that he was the father of tyranny. This means that the Constitution has always been a tyrannical document. Please note that the people of Washington do not elect a congressman or a senator. For this is not needed because Washington has a tyrannical government. Congress has sole power over Washington and only Washington. Congress is given power and authority to operate under Article 1, Section 8, Clauses 1, 16, 18 and the Bill of Rights. Those powers are very specific. The power to run Washington, D.C. is absolutely unlimited. This means that there were two constitutional governments in America. One was the government of the United States, Washington, D.C., which is power over Washington. The other was the government of the United States of America, which is power over the rest of the 50 states America. Now on to Amendment 14. It reads in part, all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States. Two questions come to mind after reading the 14th Amendment. Question number one. What were we before the 14th Amendment, if we were not citizens prior to the 14th Amendment? What were we? We were people who lived by God-given rights. Now what are we according to the 14th Amendment? We are citizens who live by government-granted privileges. What does that mean? It means that you do not have a government for the people and by the people. Notice, people became persons, meaning that your individuality as a people is no longer significant and that now you are just an insignificant person. This amendment states that there are two ways to become a citizen. You can be born inside Washington, D.C. or be born outside Washington, D.C. and become a naturalized citizen. A naturalized citizen is one who is not born in Washington, who voluntarily asks to become a citizen, because when you do, you become subject to the jurisdiction of the United States government of Washington. You became a naturalized citizen by voluntarily accepting a Social Security card of the United States. When you accepted a contract, Social Security card, you voluntarily gave up your sovereignty to the tyrannical government of the United States. You gave up your sovereignty to a foreign government named the government of the United States. So when you did that, you voluntarily granted total tyrannical control over you to the United States government. Personal note. That decision was made by the parents and not the adult. So therefore I say that you, the adult, did not voluntarily give up anything and that this agreement with the government is therefore null and void. The agreement by the parents should be conditional until you come of age and agree to this agreement. This would then make it binding. I, Daniel J. Towsey, am not an American, so I am not aware. Do you get your social security cards before or after you become a legally recognized adult? If it's before, then the contract is not legally binding, as you, the adult, did not agree to it. There is no law requiring you to get a social security card. You can request to have your social security number removed from government records. Another deception you should be aware of is that federal income taxes are voluntary. There is no law requiring you to pay them. There has never been such a law. Please note that the IRS operates under rules and only rules and not laws. The rules only apply to the United States citizens that voluntarily accept the rules. Personal note. Maybe it is time to ponder the idea of giving up your United States of America citizenship and become an illegal immigrant. You'll probably have more rights. This is just a thought, or better yet, after you give up your citizenship, create a new people's government. While you're at it, take back the control of the money from the Federal Reserve. Your taxes are only going to them and enriching the secret society members. You must come to the realization that the people of the United States have no money or gold reserves. That all money is loaned to the people from the Federal Reserve. It's nothing but a scam to control the people, and the secret members own everything. In reality, you have been enslaved. In the Bill of Rights, the 10th Amendment of the Constitution is another cleverly worded deception. You come to realize this after reading Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17, which says, Congress shall have the power to exercise exclusive legislation in all cases whatsoever. Amendment 10 says, the power is not delegated to the United States by the Constitution, nor prohibited by it to the states, are reserved to the states respectively or to the people. So therefore the Constitution says that the Founding Fathers gave all powers to the United States government and that all remaining power goes to the states or the people. But Article 1, Section 8, Clause 17 clearly says that this is not true. All power is solely in the hands of the United States government. So there is no power left to give to the people. The 10th Amendment destroys human rights. It does not protect them. You thought that the Congress was specifically limited to 18 powers and that if you did not give more power to them and that they did not have it. This is absolutely false. You have been deceived. Great Seal of the United States. The Founding Fathers created the Great Seal of the United States of America in 1782. In 1935, the Federal Reserve decided that it was now safe to gloat and put both sides of the seal on the back of the $1 bill. Around the outer edge of the back seal with the pyramid is written in Latin. A nut equals the announcing of the announcement of. Coptis equals the birth of. Novus equals new. Ordo equals order. Seclorum equals world. The Founding Fathers were announcing the birth of the New World Order. 23 of the 39 Founding Fathers were 33rd level Masons. A secret society. The backside of the Great Seal depicts a pyramid with a flat top and an all-seeing eye above it. This is to symbolize that the pyramid is not complete, but that they can see clearly how to complete it and that they are watching you. Note. Have you seen the pyramid they erected in Las Vegas? It is an exact replica and the top is attached with a bright light. On the front side is an eagle. The Masons put this eagle there for mystical reasons. In mysticism, the eagle is a symbol of initiation. The eagle is of great antiquity, figuring in the symbolic inventory of the Egyptians as the sun. The eagle was sacred to the sun. The eagle was a bird consecrated to the sun in Egypt. The eagle also represented the great Egyptian sun god Amun-Ra. Another explanation for the eagle is that it is supposed to be the only creature that can look directly into the sun. So the concealed meaning behind the eagle is that the eagle can see the sun god and that man needs the eagle to be able to go to the sun god. This eagle has 32 feathers on one wing and 33 on the other. This eagle does not represent one of God's creations, as God's creations are perfect. The numbers 32 and 33 are relevant Masonic numbers. Important note, the Masons do not worship the God of the Bible. They claim that he does not even exist. They only worship the God of Lucifer. The New World Order's principle is atheism in religion, anarchy in politics, and no property in the economic sphere. In the early 6th century, Pope Felix III said, "Not to oppose error is to approve it. And indeed to neglect to confound evil men when we can do it is no less a sin than to encourage them. It is time to oppose error. It is time to confound evil men. It is time to oppose the New World Order." Note, the source of most of this information is from a 1990 lecture by Ralph Epperson of Tucson, Arizona. Shown on the video America's Secret Destiny made by Publius Press. You may wonder why I, a non-American, would be interested or care what happens in the USA. Well, the answer is simple. The USA is the heart of the New World Order, which affects every human on this planet. All this has been possible because they took control of the money in 1913. There is no democracy if the people do not control the money. So therefore democracy has become nothing but a deceptive illusion. Quote, from Montesquieu, "There can be no liberty where the legislative and executive powers are united in the same body of magistrates." Definitions. A sovereign, a citizen that lives by God-given inalienable rights. A citizen, one who lives by government-granted privilege. Privileges can be taken away by the grantor at any time. Rights cannot be taken away except by the grantor, in this case meaning the Creator God of the Bible. Despot, a king invested with absolute power or ruling without any control from men, constitution, or laws. Tyranny. The definition of tyranny as listed in Webster's 1828 dictionary states, "One arbitrary or despotic exercise of power. The exercise of power over subjects, or not requisite for the purposes of government." Hence tyranny is often synonymous with cruelty or oppression. Too cruel government or discipline, as the tyranny of a master. 3. Unresisted or cruel power. 4. Absolute monarchy, cruelty administered. 5. Severity, rigor, inclemency. Other definitions of tyranny. Despotic exercise of power, absolute monarchy or absolute power. Tyranny. Federalist Paper Pound Sign 47. The accumulation of all powers. Legislative, executive and judiciary. In the same hands, whether are one, a few, or many, and whether hereditary, self-approved, or elective, may justly be pronounced the very definition of tyranny, also. A tyrannical concentration of all the power of government in the same hands. This information has been brought to you by a Truth Soldier on August 14, 2007. The American.